गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट ज्योमेट्री पार्ट विद चैप्टर नंबर 6, लाइंस एंड एंगल्स। दिस इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग चैप्टर, ट्रस्ट मी यू विल हैव ऑल द फन व्हाइल सॉल्विंग द क्वेश्चंस ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। सो लेट अस बिगिन विद सम बेसिक टर्म्स एंड डेफिनेशंस। फर्स्ट कम लाइन। सो व्हाट इज लाइन? Line is a state having no endpoints and it can be extended from both sides. You can extend from these sides or either you can extend from this side also. Next come line segment. So line segment is a part of line having two endpoints. Next come ray. Ray is also a part of line having only one endpoint and it can be extended from only one side. Then come angle. So what is angle and how it is formed? An angle is formed when two rays originate from same point, meaning two rays originate from same point, one ray and second ray, then form angle. Then comes adjacent angles. Adjacent angles. What are adjacent angles? Two angles are called adjacent if they have common vertex. So what is vertex here? Vertex, two rays originate from same point. That same point is called vertex of angle and the two rays are called arms of the angle. Arms of angle. So, two angles are called adjacent if they have common vertex, common arm and non-common arms are on different side of common arm. Diagram. Here two angles are formed and both angles are adjacent to each other. Why? Because they have common vertex and one common arm and two non-common arms lie on different sides of common arm. One on this side and second on this side. So next come linear pair. Linear pair of angles, when sum of adjacent angle, when sum of two adjacent angles is 180 degree, then two angles become linear pair or two angles form linear pair. See, first of all, angle should be adjacent and then sum should be 180 degree. If this angle is 60 degree and this angle is 120 degree, then these two angles form a linear pair. Next, questions based on linear pair. This is for practice, not in your NCERT textbook. So, you have to find out angle BOC and angle AOC. And these are given. So here observe 5x plus 7x is equal to what? 5x and 7x are two angles adjacent to each other and also form a linear pair. So 5x plus 7x is equal to 180 degree, reason linear pair. 5x plus 7x becomes 12x is equal to 180 degree. Now x is equal to 180 degree divided by 12. 180 degree divided by 12 is equal to what? Is equal to 15 degree. Now you not have to find out only x, we have to find out the angle BOC and AOC. Now angle BOC is equal to 7x. Put the value of x here. 7 into 15 is equal to 5, 105, and angle AOC is equal to 5x. Again put the value 15 degree. 15 into 5 is equal to 75 degree. So we have calculated the two angles BOC and angle AOC with the help of linear pair. Okay, next, second question. Again it's for your practice, not in your NCERT book. Here find x. How we will solve this question? How we will solve, find the value of x here? See, x plus 4 plus x plus 2x is equal to what? X plus 4, x, 2x is equal to 180 degree. Reason, we will not mention here linear pair because here not two angles, there are three angles. So we will write here straight line angle. So this becomes 2x plus x, 3x, 3x plus x, 4x, 4x plus 4 is equal to 180 degree. Now solve this linear equation. 180 degree minus 4, 4x is equal to 176, x is equal to 176 upon 4. X is equal to 44. Next, now we will solve exercise 6.1, question number 1. Lines AB and CD intersect at O. Statement is given in your textbook. Angle AOC plus angle BOE is equal to 70 degree, angle BOD is equal to 40 degree, and you have to find out angle BOE and reflex of angle COE. Diagram is also given. How we will solve this question? See, on line AB, on line AB, angle AOC plus angle COE plus angle BOE is equal to what? किसी के इक्वल आ रहा है, इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री, बिकॉज स्ट्रेट लाइन एंगल. नाउ वी कैन इंटरचेंज द टर्म इन एडिशन. एओसी एज इट इज प्लस राइट बीओई फर्स्ट, बीओई प्लस COE इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री. एंगल AOC प्लस एंगल BOE इक्वल टू 70 डिग्री, विच इज गिवन इन द स्टेटमेंट ऑलरेडी. 70 डिग्री प्लस एंगल COE इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री. नाउ एंगल COE इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री माइनस 70 डिग्री. This becomes 110 degree. So angle COE is 110 degree. Now we have not to find out angle COE. We have to find out reflex of angle COE. So what is reflex of angle? Reflex of COE. Reflex of an angle which is greater than 180 degree and less than 360 degree. Now, if we have to find out reflex of COE, then we will minus 110 from 360 degree is equal to 250 degree. See, if your angle is this COE, then reflex is this outer side, so which lies between 180 to 360 degree. Now what we have to find out, we have to find out the angle BOE. BOE on line CD. Now we will work on line CD. See angle COE plus angle BOE plus angle BOD is equal to 180 degree. See with the help of diagram, angle COE plus BOE plus BOD. This becomes 180 degree. Now value of COE is 110 degree plus angle BOE as it is plus value of angle BOD is given in the statement, that is 40 degree is equal to 180 degree. Now angle BOE plus 150 degree is equal to 180 degree. So calculate. BOE is equal to 180 degree minus 150 degree becomes 30 degree. So angle BOE is 30 degree. Got it? Next, second question of exercise 6.1. What we have given, lines XY and MN intersect at O. Diagram is already given. So this diagram is given in book. We have given the value of angle POE, that is 90 degree. Also given ratio of A raised to B, that is 2:3. Find C. So what we will do here? Let angle A is equal to 2x. We let the common ratio of A and B, that is x. So angle A becomes 2x and B becomes 3x. Now on line XY, angle B plus A plus angle POY is equal to 180 degree. Reason, straight line angle. Again, you will not mention here linear pair because it is not a pair, here three angles. So we will write straight line angle. Now put the value of B, that is 3x, plus value of A, 2x, plus value of angle POY, 90 degree, is equal to 180 degree. Now 3x plus 2x is equal to 5x plus 90 degree is equal to 180 degree. 5x is equal to 180 degree minus 90 degree. 5x is equal to 180 degree minus 90 degree is equal to 90 degree. Now x is equal to 90 upon 5 is equal to 18. X is equal to 18. Now value of A is equal to 2x. So put the value of x here, 18 is equal to 36, and B is equal to 3x. 3 into 18 is equal to 54 degree. But we have to find out the value of C. So for C, what we will do? On line MN. Now we will work on line MN. See, MN line. Here, angle B plus C forms linear pair. So B plus C is equal to 180 degree. Value of B, 54 degree, plus C is equal to 180 degree. Now C is equal to 180 degree minus 54. So C is equal to, minus kar do inko, 10 minus 4, 6. This is 126 degree. So value of C is 126. This completes the question. Next we will solve the third question of exercise 6.1. Question number third. Again, diagram is given in the book. So, we have given angle PQR is equal to angle PRQ. This is given to us. So what to prove? To prove angle PQS is equal to angle PRT. Now ये question proof करने वाला है, कोई value find out करने वाला नहीं है. So observe from the diagram, angle PQR, this angle, and angle PQS, this angle. Both angles form linear pair. So angle PQS plus angle PQR is equal to 180 degree. Solution. Reason, linear pair. Next, in the similar way, angle PRQ and PRT. These two angles form linear pair, so their sum will be 180 degree. Give it name as 1 and this as 2. Now from both equations 1 and 2, right hand side of both equations is 180 degree, which is equal, so their left hand side will also be equal. PQS plus angle PQR is equal to angle PRQ plus PRT. Now जो given था उसका हमने एक बार भी use नहीं किया. क्या गिवन है? एंगल पी क्यू आर इज इक्वल टू एंगल पी आर क्यू. पी क्यू आर इज इक्वल टू एंगल पी आर क्यू. सो नाउ वी विल यूज द गिवन स्टेटमेंट. एंगल पी क्यू एस प्लस वी कैन पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ एंगल पी क्यू आर इज इक्वल टू एंगल पी आर क्यू. सो हियर वी यूज द गिवन स्टेटमेंट इज इक्वल टू एंगल पी आर क्यू plus angle PRT. So this angle is equal on both sides and this will get cancelled. So what we left? Angle PQS is equal to angle PRT. And what we have to prove? We have to prove PQS is equal to angle PRT. Hence completes the proof. Hence proof. Next comes fourth question of exercise 6.1. In fourth question, also diagram is given to us. What is given? Given is sum of x plus y is equal to w plus z. And to prove AOB is a line. So how we will prove this question? See, x, y, z, w. Sum of these four